In this video, we're gonna take a look at the new Mark II version of the 7Artisans 60mm macro lens. This is a macro lens for APS-C mirrorless cameras. And here to the right, you can see the old version, the Mark I. And as you can see, the new version is considerably smaller and in general just looks better and more modern. Also, the new version does not have this protruding tube that the old one had, so that's nice. The focusing ring and aperture ring feel smooth and nice. One thing though that is a bit irritating is that the aperture ring does not have even spacing. So the spacing between 11, 8, 16 and so on is very tight, while it is broad between 2.8 and 4. And also it does not have any clicks, which is a bit of a problem, as we will discuss more later. This is a completely manual lens, no electrical contacts whatsoever. The lens cap is a bit of a disappointment. It does not screw on or click on, it is simply held by a vacuum, which doesn't hold it very well. The aperture blades are pretty smooth, and as you will see later, they produce a very nice bokeh. And yeah, the lens is very compact, and together with a Sony a6000, it makes for a very compact setup. Let's go out and try to shoot some insects with this lens and see how the photos look. This lens is available for the major APS-C mounts, Sony E-mount, Fujifilm X, EOS M, Nikon Z, and also for Micro Four Thirds. And the maximum magnification is 1x. So if you're photographing very small insects, such as this weevil here, you will have to crop quite a bit. The working distance of this lens at 1x magnification is around 9 cm, and that means the distance between the front of the lens and your subject. And that is pretty good and what one would expect for a lens like this. Today, when I'm recording this video, this lens is not for sale yet anywhere, but word on the street is that it would cost around $180, so it will definitely be a budget macro lens and one of the cheapest macro lenses on the market. So what about image quality? You've already seen some sample photos and I will show you a lot more in the rest of this video, but I have to say that I have nothing at all to complain about when it comes to the image quality. It is not the sharpest lens that I've ever used, but compared to other macro lenses, I think it performs well. I could not see any problems with chromatic aberration or serious distortion or anything like that. And it even handles pretty well when shooting against bright lights. So yeah, very good image quality, especially for the price tag. There was one thing though that annoyed me a lot when I was out shooting with this lens, and that is that the aperture ring is at the front of the lens and that the aperture is clickless and that the aperture ring turns pretty smoothly. This is a big issue for me because when I'm focusing, it is very easy to by accident touch the aperture ring, so I change the aperture by accident. And this together with the fact that the aperture ring is not linear, that the apertures around f8, 11 and 16 and so on are extremely tightly together, so you just have to nudge it a small bit, which is easy to do because it's clickless, and then you will get the wrong aperture. This is a big problem. I had to check the aperture before each photo just to see that I hadn't touched it. So yeah, this is a real issue, and this was not an issue on the old Mark I version of the lens, because then the aperture ring was at the base of the lens. And I think the reason they moved it to the front of the lens is probably to simplify the lens design, but that has a big cost in terms of handling. So if there is one big thing I want to complain about with this lens, it is the aperture ring. But if you can forgive the sloppy design of the aperture ring, I think this is a very good macro lens for your money. If you're looking to try macro photography and you want a cheap and compact lens, I think this is a pretty good choice. Of course, you could save even more money and buy the old version, but that one is a lot bigger and has that irritating protruding tube at the front. And also, I think that this lens renders a bit nicer. I think actually that the bokeh of this lens is a bit nicer than the old Mark I version. So, a solid budget option, I have to say. But in this price class, around $200, I would also urge you to look at the Micael 85mm macro lens. It is a bit bigger and not as nicely built as the 7Artisans, but the Micael 85mm goes to 1.5 times magnification. And if you're looking to shoot small insects, as I am shooting in this video, 1.5 times magnification is a very welcome thing to have in a macro lens. As you've seen in the sample photos in this video, when you're shooting small insects at 1 time magnification, you have to crop a lot if you want the insects to take up a big part of your photo. This lens can of course be used for other things than photographing insects. Since it can focus to infinity, you can also use it for landscapes, for example, and it seems to be doing quite well in this department as well. And also it is great for portraits. I spent some time photographing my family with this lens and it performs very well even at f2.8, super sharp and nice. So to summarize, I think this lens is a good purchase if you can forgive the sloppy aperture ring. If you like this video, I recommend you to check out my free inspiration newsletter about photography that comes out once per month. Go sign up now at mwroll.com to get your copy in your inbox. And also please check out my Instagram for more of my photography, and do subscribe to this channel. I post new videos about macro photography every week. Over and out. See you soon again. Bye bye.